Welcome to Rectory Set Cook, a Diocese of Scranton showdown of pastor chefs, presented by the Hawk Family Foundation. Bon appetit.
Oh, and welcome to the 2023 edition of Rectory Set Cook. I'm Father Joe Elston, pastor here at St. John the Evangelist Church, where this year I am making a peach galette. And it's a French dessert. Actually, galette. Galette actually stands for hand pie. Hand pie. And it's a French term. And it's a very easy dessert and really delicious. Made a dessert last year too. French toast bread pudding. Sort of hung up on this French thing. Well, anyway, so we're channeling Julia Child today with the French chef. And this rich dessert is going to have peaches and sugar and cinnamon and all the good stuff with it. And you make it on pastry dough, sort of like a phyllo dough sort of thing, kind of thing. All right, it's really easy. So here's how we do it. First, you have dough, which I made myself. No, I didn't, actually.
With his French hat?
With my French hat, yes. So you need this particular thing with a little flour to put on the pieces of dough. All right, just make sure it gets a little coated with a little bit of flour so that it cooks a little better and takes care of itself in the oven. You need the puff pastry, which is what I've got here. You need the peaches, what you're going to do with the peaches is you're going to put the sugar in there and the cinnamon and cook that out for a little bit till the peaches get nice and soft. And the mix is really kind of good to go in the middle. You want to cook them first. That's fresh peaches. You peel them, of course. Slice them, peel them, put them in the middle, and make that all nice and neat. So, once the peach mix is all ready, like it is now too, we did that to save some time. We're going to put some of this in the middle of your puff pastry dough. Put the filling. Looks delicious. Smells even better. Too bad you can't smell it. But you will when you make it. You will when you make it. We can go up to about 2 inches or so from the edge of the pastry dough. We're going to see how much of this we have. We're going to make 2. Really easy to do. Very delicious. I would not give you anything that wasn't delicious.
That's right. We know how to eat. If nothing else, we know how to eat.
We have Jane and Midge with us today, our rectory staff, and as our able-bodied assistants who did a lot of the prep work. We have Mike on the camera. Hi, Mike.
Hello, Father.
And he's doing well.
The ladies.
Hi, Mike.
We're going to load that up, use all of our mixture, put this together. Okay. Now, the next step is going to be to crimp this dough all the way around it. You can roll it if you want, but I'm choosing this method to kind of crimp it and fold it like a pie crust. Roll it up, pinch it, crimp it all the way around like this. Very good. So that you're surrounding your peach mixture in there.
Looks good.
Looks good already, it does, even though it's not baked quite yet. But it's very good, very easy to do. This cooking the peaches doesn't take long at all, does it, Midge and Jane?
No, Father. Not at all.
All right. So, I'm going to do the same thing here. Crimp this up a little bit.
We could just slide it right on.
Yeah, we're going to slide it onto the baking sheet. The oven is already preheated. That's very important. Preheat the oven. Don't slide this in a cold oven. Preheat the oven to 350 degrees. Getting it ready for these beautiful little gelettes.
Crimp that a little bit more on the other one. On that one.
This one?
Yeah, crimp
it. On this side.
Yeah.
You always get told what to do.
That's right.
You don't want it to be
creeping
out of there.
That's why we're here.
You don't want it to I could be creeping out of there. I'm not exactly known for my culinary skills, but we're doing the best we can. Happy to participate again in this Rectory Set Cook. Now, before you put it in the oven, you're going to, well, I think the milk would go first, right?
The milk.
Milk. You're going to paint a little of this with a little brush milk along the side here. Do this. That'll give it a nice gold crunchy finish. Be generous. I'll tell you why in a minute. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Look good, Jane?
Looks very good. Mm-hmm. Do we very get to good. Try it?
No.
This is for the Rectory Set Cook audience only. Oh. Which is me. So I get to eat it. And if there are no repercussions, like no belly aches or trips to the emergency room, you can have some. Now that you got all that milk on there, you're going to sprinkle a little mix of sugar and cinnamon, I believe, right? Just sugar, a little mix of that around on the crust. Oh yeah, that's gonna help that.
Yes, it is.
It's gonna make that elegant.
Oui, oui.
Not just some, not just some simple French dessert.
That's a raw sugar, actually.
Raw sugar. Okay. Be generous with that. That's going to melt in there, make it nice and golden and crunchy. Very good. Very nice. It's looking incredible.
Yes,
it is. I hope
you
can see it close up. We're about to slide it onto the cookie sheet.
And pop it in the oven.
And pop it in the preheated oven, 350 degrees. This could use a little more right here. It may surprise you, but I like a lot of sugar and cinnamon. And these rich desserts, well, it's not going to do much to your A1C. Doesn't do much to mine. So I think you should be okay.
Does wonders for your taste buds, though.
Does wonders for your taste buds. Okay, we're going to slide these on here to the cooking sheet. Well, thank you, Jane.
You're welcome.
Let's hope this slides a little easier than I think it's going to.
How about a bigger spatula?
Maybe a little bigger spatula. It'll help to give it a little encouragement.
Midge, how about a flipper? Like
hurry it up, Midge.
What do you want?
Like a thick
wound
in?
Maybe?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't cut.
Very good.
There you go.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Light our parchment paper lining the baking sheet here. All the ingredients will be listed on the recipe and all the necessities as far as parchment, etc.
Maybe you were better off holding it yourself, were you?
Maybe. A little sluggish coming out of there. You could make it in the dish on the parchment, which is probably would have been a good idea. Trying to slide it on there. Whoops. A little sluggish. Well, like I said, best idea probably would be to make it on the parchment paper, assemble it on the parchment. Here we go. That's a little better.
There we go.
There we go. Just make it look prettier. There we go. Straighten that all out. And we're going to pop it in the oven for 350 degrees for 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Here we go. Excellent. Pop it in your oven, 20 minutes. And that's it.
We're done. Wee wee!
Very helpful if you have a cleanup crew like I do, and then you don't have to worry about cleaning up. We'll be back to you in 20 minutes. Okay, 20 minutes is up. It's time to take our Gallette out of the oven. Our peach Gallette should be completely done by now. Here we go. Oh, well, it got a little leaky, but it's okay. That I can tell you how to fix really easy.
Don't get burned.
Don't get burned. It is hot, though. It is hot. All right. There is our hand pie. Now, I think if you just put the peaches a little closer together and crimp it up a little better, but it looks really good and delicious. The smell is great. Too bad you can't smell it. So that's our peach galette, our French edition for today. We're going to put the recipe online from St. John the Evangelist Church. This is Rectory Set Cook, and we are happy to be part of it again this year. Thanks to Jane and Midge and Mike for doing the taping today, and Jane and Midge for prepping and helping me do this. So it looks delicious, a little leaky, like I said. Who cares? It's still going to be delicious. Good luck with it. Have fun. Vote for us, St. John the Evangelist Church. Part of the money, a very good percentage, I think it's 50-50, goes to the Catholic Social Services, part of it to the parish, and it'll be great. So have a good time watching the videos, especially ours. Thanks for looking in, and good luck. Take care. Thank you.